Siobhan Arnott, and I'm a printmaker, and I'm going to be part of the West End Studio Tour in September 2024. And just want to introduce a little bit about my background. So I was a management consultant for about 25 years, and then I stepped away in about 2018 and decided to take up printmaking. I'd been taking some courses, and it really took me back to memories of my childhood. So my mom was a printmaker, and she really, just when I walked into the Ottawa School of Art and started taking printmaking classes, just the sounds, you know, even of the roller pulling ink or the sound of the press turning really brought me back to that childhood. And I immediately felt quite at home with printmaking and decided to leave my career and step into the Ottawa School of Art and take a diploma course. And so I ended up doing a 3-year program, graduating in 2022. One of my bodies of work is called Breath and Memory. And it started with a piece I did for my graduation, which is actually called Breath and Memory. And it is a picture of me hiking in the West Coast Trail in BC. It was actually my daughter that took that picture. My eldest daughter, Kira, is a photographer. And that started me on a journey of creating very detailed and more detailed lineup cuts of similar scenes, either in the West Coast Trail, or we've got some others just over here. this one is in Algonquin. It's called Destination 2. It was actually a commission by some friends who often go canoeing in this area as a family. And then I created Snow Day, which was actually one of my latest commissions for another family. And it's a compilation from photographs of the Gatineau Park. And then there's one other that's over in the far corner, and it is of my two girls working, walking in Mirabeau Conservation Area. And so these are all either 18 by 24 or a compilation of four panels of 18 by 24 lino cuts. And for those who aren't familiar with that, once I get the cat off the lino cut, this is one of my latest ones that I'm carving right now. And, so it's 18 by 24. Once again, it's got me as the hiker heading into the trail. It's meant to be sort of a nighttime scene. And some of the tools I use, are these flexi-cut carving tools. So there's a set, and they can either have a V gouge or a U gouge, and so they come in different thicknesses, but they're quite fine. And then I have what are called Fife tools. They're Swiss made. Not sure I got the pronunciation right, but they are very, very fine. So those are the ones I started using through the years. And then I have a bigger set. So it's a multi-tool process. What I do is a mixture of, I'll take the raw lino, and I will take often a photograph that I've taken or a daughter's taken, and I will use carbon and actually transfer the bulk of the image, and then I will draw the details because they end up being quite design oriented. Mm-hmm. And then as I'm carving, I will use a Sharpie marker, I don't have a thick one here, to color in so I can see where I've carved. So the black is actually a Sharpie marker because the original lino is like a brown color.
Mm.
And then once this is carved, I would go to my inking table, so the glass top table, and I would ink that. And then once it's inked and I have paper that's dampened, I'd put this into my press and run that through the press with a piece of Stonehenge or other type of printmaking paper. As you notice, this is actually my symbol that I use, and I use it on my website or my logo. And I'm not sure if the pronunciation right, but Labrach, I believe it is, and it's essentially meaning resilient or strong. And so just a lot of my Breath and Memory series is very much about how we, well, certainly I do, and I know a lot of people go outdoors and spend a lot of time or find ways, whatever it is for them, to build resilience and strength. And I have a piece that's not out called Still I Rise, which is actually another 4-panel piece, and it has my daughter climbing up a very tall ladder. So it's a 3-foot by 4-foot piece. And it's very much around that point when you're faced with a challenge, you have to make a decision. You know, do you kind of get down and depressed? And, you know, sometimes we can't help going through that. Or do you make that decision to keep moving forward and find the resources? And so I've been a real advocate for mental health. My mom had a severe mental illness, and she was an artist and managed to still be an artist most of her life, but, you know, faced a lot of challenges. So a lot of my work speaks to mental health issues and how to kind of manage them and to work through them in life, and that we all need to take care of our mental wellness.